Hello, my fellow collectors. My name is Brian Volkweiss. I am the founder and current CEO of the Nacelle Company. Basically, I'm reaching out to you today because I received a letter from Mattel this past Friday telling me that a copyright we had acquired over a year ago for a toy line named RoboForce, and it was addressed to me. I got the letter right here. Dear Mr. Volkweiss, that's me, CEO, telling me that I and my company had stolen the name Max Steel from Mattel's toy line called Max Steel. So, first of all, I didn't steal anything. I bought a copyright to a toy that went on the market around 1983, 1984. Mattel's Max Steel went on sale around 1999. I am not a math whiz, but I believe that's about 15 years or so that the original RoboForce predated Mattel's toy called Max Steel. But nevertheless, that, you know, these pesky facts didn't bother the lawyers at Mattel. So in the letter, they accuse me. Like I said, they accuse me of stealing this name. They say, as you know, and no doubt intended, Nacelle's Max Steel's goods and copyright mark infringe Mattel's long-established rights to its Max Steel. Then they accuse me of not only stealing it, but they think I'm a criminal mastermind because our Max Steel is M-A-X-X S-T-E-L-L-E. Somebody over 40 years ago that was involved with designing RoboForce, they came up with the name Max Steel, and they're the ones who did the two X's and the E's. But Mattel accuses me, and they say, with the addition of a superfluous, glad I pronounced that right, and legally irrelevant X at the end of Max and E at the end of Steel, it is so obvious and outrageous as to suggest that Nacelle purposely intends to trade on Mattel's marks and valuable goodwill. So Mattel is basically saying that one of our character names that was named, again, over four decades ago when I was like five or eight. Again, I'm bad at math, which is probably not a great thing for a CEO, but that's why I always put it in quotes. But anyway, that I and my company added an extra X and an E at the end of Steel because we wanted to steal this, pun intended, from Mattel. Then they go on to say, while the original ideal toy company, Max Steel, created in 1984, was a 2-foot-tall plastic robot that rolled, Nacelle's Max Steel toy is a 7.5-inch action figure that is confusingly and substantially similar to several action figures in Mattel's Max Steel line shown above. And then it was very nice of them to do this. They enclosed pictures of some of the characters. There's two more. So, and then the other thing they did, which was very nice, they enclosed pictures of our own product. So, and they said, again, they said that our character Max Steel looks just like their character Max Steel. So here's what ours looks like. And again, just to make sure you were paying attention, that's what theirs looks like. And they say it's too similar. Nacelle's Max Steel figure also, and this is, I mean, guilty as charged, I have to admit, Nacelle's Max Steel figure also appears to come with futuristic weapons and attachments, just like Mattel's Max Steel and action figures. So here's what they're saying. And again, I don't have to read into this. They enclosed pictures. Maybe they didn't think I could read. But they showed a picture of the 2 foot tall robot that was made for God knows whatever reason 45 years ago. And they said, Mattel said, hey, your figure of Max Steel used to be 2 feet tall, but now you're making him 7 inches. That's another reason how you're copying us. And you had attachments. You guys had attachments. Our Max Steel has attachments. How can you do that? I brought this little guy. And I am not an expert on the metric system. I am not the expert on anything, but I do believe this is less than 2 feet tall. If I had to guess, he's probably about, I don't know, 6 or 7 inches. And he's got this thing in his hand. What is that? I am pretty sure that qualifies as an attachment. So about 15 years before, by the way, notice the great suction cup. That has nothing to do with this letter. I just always love to point out the suction cups. But apparently, the Mattel Corporation is very threatened that we have added our own attachments, which again, we didn't. This attachment is almost as old as I am. And that we shrunk our figures down from 2 feet to 7 inches. But again, pretty sure this is less than 2 feet. By the way, the other thing I forgot to mention, let's talk about their character for a second. They said their character was an anthropomorphic robot. No, it's not. Like, they don't even understand their own character. Their character is a human being that, like, sometimes fights robots, sometimes puts on a suit that's kind of robotic-like. Still a human being. Pretty sure that's not an anthro. Although, we did copy their accessories. That is true. Oh, no, we didn't. Look at that. Boom. Look at that accessory. That is a crazy space weapon of some sorts. And then, and then they say to me, if Nacelle fails to confirm in writing but by the close of business on Friday, July 8th, that it will cease promoting or selling anything under the Max Steel mark and that it will withdraw its application for the Max Steel mark. Mark means trademark. Mattel is prepared to vigorously protect its valuable intellectual property rights, yada, 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 and then basically come after you in district court. That's what happened this past Friday at about 3 o'clock when I'm with my family having lunch right before the July 4th holiday. But listen, there's a lot of really bad things going on in the world right now. And I fully admit, I feel stupid talking about toys at this time in our civilization's history. But I got to go to work tomorrow. I got to make money. I got to feed my family. We have a lot of employees. And again, we are making the toys right now. And these things are going to be shipping to California very soon. Like I said, they're already in production. And then Mattel, who I should also mention this, I don't think this will surprise anybody. We know a lot of people at Mattel. They know us. They beg us frequently to do a Toys That Made Us on Hot Wheels and other things. We have constantly, I'd say once every week or once every other week, we're talking to their staff. They're talking to our staff. So why somebody couldn't just pick up the phone and say, hey, can we talk about this? Why they had to have a letter accusing me of stealing their name and messing with their copyright, to me, that's what a bully does. That is what a multi-billion dollar company, public company, does to intimidate a small company that is just starting to get into the toy business. This is a massive company that has a relationship with a smaller company sending a letter like this because they want to be a bully. So first of all, I want many of you, or all of you, if you care, to know what's going on. Because again, in my heart, I'm a toy collector and I'm a documentarian. And part of what I try to do is show you, the public, things that are going on from my point of view as somebody that's in their, I guess, mid-40s, almost late 40s. I'm going to end this video, probably the longest I've ever shot, I'm going to end it on 2 points. Number one, to Mattel, we will not back off. We will never back off. If you want to pursue this, we will see you in court. It's not cool what you're doing. Pick someone else to pick on, or better yet, don't pick on anybody. Number two, focus on making great toys. Focus on creating great IP and great stories. And don't focus on picking on little companies that are joining the toy business. But if you really want to send a message of support to us, I would really appreciate it if you would buy our version of Max Steel, two X's with an E at the end, and also Wrecker. He's this big old yellow and black guy with lots of arms and crazy stuff like that. Because we are not going to stop. The Nacelle Company will not stop making toys. We will be making RoboForce. We will be making Max Steel. It will say Max Steel on the box. And we're not going to be bullied by Mattel. But if you got through this whole thing, I really appreciate it. And if you have any questions, put them in the comments. And I will do my best to answer everything. And yeah, keep on collecting. Have a good day.